Josh's Order Corner.
That's me.
This one is exciting. It is so exciting, in fact, that we are not going to wait till Sunday to reveal it. We're going to do it today, Friday, April 5th, right here. Look at this. Now, normally it is every Sunday at 7 p.m. that we do Vinyl Ventures, a musical journey here at Josh's Hoarder Corner. We open up a record, we show the variant to you. But like I said, today we are doing it right here, right now. As I look around for my knife that I don't know what I did with, it's sort of going to pop up in the Barlow. Maybe. This is an old one. This is my great grandpa's knife. It's rusty as shit. So let's go ahead and crack this open. Now, the reason this is a special one is because this has been like a little game that has been getting played with Trustkill Records, where they were releasing very low numbers of this album over the past few weeks. It started off, I would say, 3 weeks ago-ish. They dropped 10, and then there was 8. And then this one right here was 5. There were only 5 of this variant of It Dies Today, the Caitiff Choir, that were released. And I managed to snag one. Because if you watch their newsletter, if you watch their patterns, you get an idea of when they're going to be doing the drops. And I work from home, so it's a lot easier for me than some people to have my computer open and ready to go. I started watching their merch site at 9:50. So about 10, well, was it 10 that they went on sale or 11? I started watching about 10 minutes before they dropped. And slowly but surely, you started seeing like pictures change. There was the Bleeding Through album, This Is Love, This Is Murderous, and It Dies Today. And I think Memphis May Fire might have been there too, but I wasn't really watching that one. But you started to see like the thumbnails were showing different variants, and then you loaded in the purchase screen. And finally, there were two different variants available for Bleeding Through and It Dies Today. A purple and the one that we have here that I am struggling opening. Now, I left a comment on the Facebook of Trustkill last week. Like, I'm going to say that this is the stupidest idea of all time until I'm able to snag one. And then I'm going to say that this was the greatest idea. So it was the stupidest idea until this week on the second, when this went live. And I managed to snag one. And then it was the greatest idea of all time. This is It Dies Today. It Dies Today is from Buffalo, New York. They are a metalcore band that started in 2001. They achieved success in 2004 with the release of this album, Caitiff Choir. That I might be saying wrong. I honestly don't know how to say it. See, what else can I tell you about them? Then they had Sirens. They had some lineup changes, and then they broke up, and that was sad, and it made me sad, but they're back together. They are back together, and they are playing Cleveland on May 20th, and will I be there? You're damn right I will be. I'm stoked. I bought tickets as soon as they went on sale when it was announced they would be playing at the Foundry. And then today, we received word that it was going to be moved to the Winchester. So I only hope that the Winchester has their shit together that day, because their sound is pretty bad. So we're really hoping for a good sounding show. This is the one of 5. It is this nice splatter variant, It Dies Today, from Trustkill Records, clear with the blue white splatter. It looks fantastic. This album has, oh my gosh, bangers from start to finish. Severed Ties, Yield, Severed Heads, The Radiance, Depravity Waltz, A Threnodity for Modern Romance, Marigold, Freak, Gasoline, Fire, Accidents, The Caitiff Choir, Revelations, Nania, Caitiff Choir, Defeatism, Artist Integration, Appreciation, and then I skipped my promise, the first track on there. There's a nice pic. Look at that hair. Look at the hair on those gents. Oh, boy. Man, this is like a time capsule, a complete time capsule. So they were on quite a few soundtracks and compilations back in the day, as well as releasing their albums, Masters of Horror, Solve 6, it looks like. Or was it Soft 4? I don't know. Sirens, Lividity, those are their two albums. Former members, current members, we're looking at Nicholas Brooks, lead vocals from 2001 to 7, and then he was back 2012 to 15, and he is back now. Chris Capelli, Steve Lemke, Mike Hadalak, and Nick Maruso. That would be what we're seeing in May with this new run of shows they're doing. On September 15th, 2023, It Dies Today released a new song, Buried by Black Clouds, with an accompanying music video, and they appeared at Furnace Fest in Birmingham. I missed that Furnace Fest. I did not go to that Furnace Fest. There were some great bands that played, including It Dies Today. So I'm stoked. Actually, let's leave this out, because we're going to listen to one of the songs, just like we always do. I'm going to be very gentle with this. One of five. Oh, man. Oh, man. I can't believe it. Let's go ahead and add this. And we are going to, you know what? Let's change the layout here. Boom. Spicy. And here we go. It Dies Today. Severed ties yield severed heads. From Trustkill Records. I don't want you back. I was feeling silent, murderous. So I had the sense that you was alone. With passion, that possession. I suffer the pain. Sweet, she looks at me. Says it's me to come back to her. Love this song so much. Like, this is, like I said, it's a time capsule. This, like, takes me back. The music, the metalcore at this time was so fucking good. They just don't make them this way anymore. And this is why we need to make sure the sound is on top notch at that Winchester show. Like, this is gonna be a rowdy, rowdy show. I can't believe they're back. I'm so happy about it. Like, it makes me so happy to see this again. A lot of the bands from then, like, Beating Crew's doing shows again. Ace of Base doing shows again. It's amazing. I want to see Modern Ashes start doing even more shows. Like, they did a handful not long ago, but I want to see more. Oh, little piggy head in the sink there. So good. Now, I'm not trying to be a negative Nancy. I'm not trying to be a bummer about them playing the Winchester now. When they were announced for the Foundry, I was like, no, that is such a small, weird-shaped venue. I want more room to see them. So when they were moved to the Winchester, I was like, no, I just have a complaint about everything. I've only been to the Winchester once before, and it was for He Is Legend. And the sound was just awful. And that was such a huge bummer, because that is a great band. And you want to be able to hear the band that you're paying money to see. So honestly, my hope is that that was just a one-off and they have their shit together for the most part on other shows, because this is going to be a great one. Local hardcore kids, Last Gasp is opening, and then there's still apparently a to be announced band that's going to be there as well. So will I see you at the Cleveland show when It Dies Today takes the stage and rips our faces off? Or will you be not there, sad about it and crying? Or do you just not live close enough and you're going to see them in your area? Let me know down below. I can't wait. And I cannot believe I managed to snag this. If you're trying to grab one of these albums, honestly, just Tuesday morning, 10 minutes before the drop, load the website and just start hitting that reload button. That's all you can do. Snag it, have PayPal. If you pay with PayPal, that was the option I chose and it went right through. So I know it's a bummer to miss out on these drops. And I know that there's going to be a lot of people who are pissed that they missed out. Don't take it out on the people who did get it. Just next time, get there early, start refreshing the page, and you can snag one of these. I think they're going to be releasing just a handful. I think they're going to be releasing it in bigger numbers in the future from what Trustkill has been saying. So just keep your eye on Trustkill's socials, and hopefully they'll have a larger run going in the future. A lot of people say that these are leftovers from the Revolver pressings. I don't know how true that is. I didn't pay attention to the Revolver ones, so I don't know what those variants looked like. But it sounds like there are more coming in bigger numbers before long. Till next time. Normally, it's every Sunday at 7 p.m. Eastern, but like I said, we had to drop this one special today because I'm so excited that I snagged this one. We'll see you soon.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do